Hello students, welcome to my channel. I am Sridhar here. Today we learn about catenation. What are the conditions necessary for catenation and test for borate radical in the lesson P block elements 1. Before going to the video, subscribe my channel by touching subscription button shown in the right hand lower corner. Thank you. Catenation. What is catenation? Catenation is an ability of an element to form chain of atoms. This can be understood by using carbon. Why we have to use carbon to study catenation? Because carbon has the highest catenation property among the elements. So we can see the definition. Carbon has a greater tendency to form a chain of bonds with itself or with other atoms, which is known as catenation. Carbon's catenation. Carbon as the valency four, one of the valency forms a covalent bond with another carbon atom. So this is known as two carbon chain. A number of two carbon compounds are exist. The second carbon atom forms covalent bond with another carbon atom. Therefore, this chain contains three carbon atom. This carbon forms covalent bond with fourth carbon atom. Therefore, the chain length goes on. Due to the catenation property of carbon, large number of organic compounds are exist in nature. Among the P block elements, 14th group elements are shows greater catenation property. The 14th group elements are carbon, silicon, germanium, tin, lead. All these 5 14th elements are having similar catenation property. Means no, carbon has the highest catenation property among the 14th group. As well as overall elements, carbon is the topmost atom, shows catenation property. After carbon, silicon shows catenation property. Then germanium and tin are almost equal in catenation property. In this group, the least catenation property shown by lead. You are seeing a series. That series is very important for examination point of view. What are the conditions necessary for catenation? Examination point of view, this is the most important question. What are the conditions necessary for catenation? Point number one. The valency of element is greater than or equal to. What is the meaning of this? The element shown catenation properties are having greater valencies. You see carbon as the valency 4. Silicon, the valency is 4. Boron, valency is 3. Phosphorus, valency is 3. So the point number 1 says about the valency of the atoms, which has to be equal to 2 or greater than 2. Therefore only carbon, silicon, boron, phosphorus are shows catenation property. Point number 2. Element have an ability to bond with itself. Carbon bond carbon, silicon bond silicon, silicon bond silicon, disilane, then sulfur bond sulfur. Example for sulfur bond sulfur is disulfur dibromide. Similarly, we have phosphorus bond phosphorus, boron bond boron. I hope that second point can be understood. Point number 3. The self bond must be as strong as its bond with other element. Yes, carbon bond carbon is strong. Similarly, carbon bond with O. Fourth point, kinetic inertness of catenated compound towards other molecules. Yes, if you see hydrocarbons are the compounds containing carbon carbon covalent bond. Hydrocarbon shows kinetic inertness towards other molecules. It's not readily reacts with other molecules. Means carbon-carbon sigma bond is strong. So all the 4 points are easy to understand. This is very important for examination point of view. The next one. Test for borate radicals. What is borate radical? It's the most important question. BO3 3- is the formula of borate radical. How we have to find the presence of borate radical? When boric acid or borate salt is heated with ethyl alcohol in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, an ester triethyl borate is formed. that ester burns with the green edged flame, and this reaction is used to identify the presence of borate. You see, this is known as Bunsen burner, burns with blue flame. Then introduce a glass rod dipped in triethyl borate, because triethyl borate is a liquid. If you show that glass in Bunsen burner's blue flame, that's turned into green. It shows the presence of borate radical, which is easy to understand. What is the chemical reaction takes place? Boric acid reacts with ethyl alcohol in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. On heating, it forms triethyl borate. Triethyl borate. Along with what? So this is an unbalanced equation. To balance this equation, see here, in triethyl borate we have three ethyl group. Therefore, in front of ethyl alcohol in the reactant side, put 3. Then count number of oxygen in the reactant side. 3 plus 3, 6. Therefore, in the product side, in triethyl borate we have 3. Therefore, in front of water, make 3. Now the entire equation is balanced. So it's easy to understand. Yes. Today we discussed about catenation, essential conditions for catenation, and identification of borate radical. I hope students, all of you, understood this without any doubt. If you like this video, share, comment, like, and don't forget to subscribe. We will meet again soon in another video. Until then, bye. Thank you.